Welcome to part 3 of how to make a Terminator effect. And this time I will show how we can take the recording we made of the face and prepare this for use for VFX. So I'm going to use Premiere Pro to do this. But it can be quite difficult for you to see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this green Atmos Ninja 5 that is now connected to the camera, so you can see exactly the same thing here. And I'm going to connect this thing to the screen and record what we see on the screen, so I can flip back and forth and you can see more the details of what I'm doing. Okay, so let me just reconnect this one to the computer. And by the way, how to do this is I have the HDMI cable from the computer and I'm going to connect this to the Ninja 5. But I have to turn off the camera first. So 1 second. Okay, now I have connected the Ninja 5 to the HDMI out from the computer. Now everything I do on the screen is also recorded on this device. So I'm start recording this here now. And I have loaded here the footage that we recorded of the face. And this is recorded in Blackmagic RAW. And this is using a logarithmic color space, so it looks quite washed out. And for VFX work, we want to use an EXR sequence. So to export this, we select the clip and then go to Okay, now I have connected the Ninja 5 to the computer via an HDMI cable. And everything we see on the screen is also recorded into this device. So I'm going to press the record button. Okay. And first we have to load in the clip recorded of the face with the markers. And this is recorded in B-RAW format, the Blackmagic B-RAW. And this we should convert to an EXR sequence that is the standard for VFX work. So let's select the clip and go to File, Export, Media. And then here we can select the format, Open EXR, and the OpenXR sequence. And then we can select how much we want to export. So this is in total 1.5 minutes, so it's quite a long clip. We're not going to need everything. But I'm just going to go ahead and export the whole sequence for now. So if you want to change it, you can just drag these markers down here to the beginning and the end of your clip. Okay. And then let's press export. First you have to select where you want to save it, and I already selected this myself. So let's now export this EXR sequence. Okay, so this is going to take 20 minutes. Okay, we're not going to sit here and wait, so I'm going to cancel this and do this offline. But now you know how to do this. Okay. So let's keep this episode short and see you next time in episode 5 of how to make a Terminator effect. And don't forget to like and subscribe.